My mom was a really difficult person to watch movies with. She had been a huge theater nerd when she was a kid and when she was in college. And one of the things that she really loved was costuming and costume design. And she had learned a lot about it and a lot about the history of it. One of the side effects of this was if we were watching a period piece, if we were watching a movie set in the, you know, in the past, a sufficiently distant past, she would suddenly chime in and start complaining and talking about how unrealistic this film was and how bad the writers were and how little research they did. And when I would ask why, she would say they didn't have that color purple in 1786. This is something I have seen come up quite a lot, is that you're watching a film or a TV show or something, and you're perfectly able to enjoy yourself until something related to your area of expertise comes up. And then from your point of view, everything falls apart and you complain about the lazy writers. This is an example of something, a term coined by Michael Crichton, and he deliberately used the name of a famous physicist when he coined it on purpose, so it would make his idea sound more important and authoritative. It's called Gell-mann Amnesia, named after Murray Gell-mann. Murray Gell-mann's the guy that predicted did a bunch of stuff on the weak interaction and stuff, but he predicted the existence of the quark and named it. Apparently, Michael Crichton, as he tells it, he was at a party with Murray Gell-mann and they were talking, and Gell-mann was complaining about how people will read the newspaper and they'll be perfectly willing to accept everything the newspaper says until they reach an article that overlaps with their area of expertise. In Gell-mann's case, that would be physics. In Michael Crichton's case, show business. And he discovers that everything this journalist is saying is wrong. Like, I actually work in this field. I know this issue. Not only have you gotten everything wrong, not only are your facts wrong and your conclusions are wrong, you often are confusing cause and effect. You're saying the opposite of what really happens. He called it amnesia because for some reason, even though a second ago you were certain that these journalists are terrible, they don't do their research and they come to all the wrong conclusions, you turn the page and you forget that and you go back to accepting everything they say. I think the only reason anyone can enjoy any movies or TV show is because we are sufficiently ignorant. If we knew enough about all these different issues, if we knew what it was like to be a lawyer or a judge or a cop, we wouldn't be able to watch Law and Order. If we knew what it was like to do these things, we would just find it riddled with inaccuracies. And our ability to enjoy something is directly proportional with the degree of ignorance we have regarding what's being presented on screen. My mom was upset because it seemed from her point of view as though the writers had done shoddy research into colors and fabrics and stuff like that. But in point of fact, the writers have probably done quite a bit of research. It's just that the research they've done is into being a good writer, into dialogue and character and tone and tension. That's the writer's job. If they do research, they're only doing enough research to give their work a veneer of verisimilitude and trick the reader into believing the things that they're writing or that the actors are saying or that the director is filming. This came up recently in my D&D game where the players in my Wednesday night D&D game were looking at a broadsheet. They were reading effectively a newspaper being distributed in the giant fantasy metropolis that they are in. And they were drawing conclusions about which faction in the world to work for based on the things they were reading in the paper. And they were saying that we should absolutely not work for this person. Look what they said about the world's villain. And I just laughed and they were like, why are you laughing? I said, well, there's an awful lot of stuff about you guys in the broadsheet. And they're like, yeah. And I said, do you feel as though you were reasonably and accurately represented? And they all stop and they're like, my God, we can't trust anything in here. Because when they read the stuff about them, they knew this was all either demonstrably wrong or being deliberately mispresented to make things more dramatic and to sell newspapers. There's no point to this. I'm not trying to tell people to be skeptical of journalism. I think journalists are critical and vital and do important work for any democracy. I love the term Gell-mann amnesia, and I love seeing it happen in the wild when people are watching a movie, and if they're a computer programmer, they just get disgusted with the way programming is shown in film, but they don't get disgusted at the rest of it, even though it's all equally inaccurate. The only thing that's accurate is drama and dialogue and character and tension. That's it. I just thought it was a cool idea for a video, and why not? It's Friday night. I hope you folks have a good weekend.